Guts, the cool epic black swordsman, childhood trauma incarnate, the berserker, depressed sad sack, are names used to describe this protagonist. Now let's take a look at what he really is and what makes his character so unique. Only through pain can a man be shaped, is the perspective with which I'd like to start this video and conduct this analysis. Because while the berserk world building is extraordinary, a church of symbolism and hidden meanings, and a realm to philosophical dilemmas as the duality between good and evil, Guts' story and agony, in my opinion at least, will remain the most impactful aspect of Berserk. The odds were stacked against him all his life since his childhood, so much that we think the author himself hates his guts. A quick look at everything he had to endure chronologically. You ready? Alright, drop the team, let's go. Mother hanged in a tree before he was being born in a pile of human guts marinating there before found by soldiers, adopted by mercenaries to make use of him as a future soldier, oh, and also sought to be played with by a pedophile which he eventually killed at a young age, eventful childhood, growing up alone as a wandering mercenary drifting between battlefields to survive, until he meets the Band of the Hulk led by the beautiful symbol of godhood, Griffith, finding a best friend, a lover, and a home in that group, which were all killed and betrayed by said god in order to become, well, more of a god, and you know, boinked said lover by force, well, kinda, and in front of who? Yup, you guessed that right, Guts. All while losing an eye in the arm by demons rendered hopeless. Of course, let's not forget he was then cursed in this now partaking a journey alone with a traumatized girlfriend which is rendered practically brainless, followed constantly by demons because of the curse and sees people around him die constantly because of the demons his curse attracts. Let me know in the comments if I forgot anything else. Now why? What exactly is the purpose of all of this? Does the author just enjoy his agony? I mean, couldn't he just have given him a typical rough shonen orphan childhood and made him overcome all obstacles and become pirate king or Hokage or something to make his point? Well, because it's simply not his point. It is exactly about that eternal painful journey itself, and even as he overcame his childhood trauma at one point and everything seemed to work out fine, tragedy awaits him right after. Deep down, Guts knows that he may never achieve a peaceful life. The closest thing that can be as his goal, aside from his revenge, is protecting his surroundings, which also was an inspiration to Bleach's Ichigo making him the most unique in the big tree. And quite honestly, it's possible he may never achieve his happy ending, and that a life of eternal struggle is all that awaits him. But you know what? He lived it. And with a good slap of realism in the face, we now know that life is not just gonna go our way, even if we work hard. We may still fail, but guess what? It was still worth it. We learn to find beauty through times of struggle. We learn to see pain not as an obstacle but an ally to partake in our growth, a stoic view of life that could be argued to be the most beneficial one. While many shonen animes have focused on the beautiful part where the hero gives a speech about not giving up to inspire people around him alongside the viewers, and while it did to an extent tremendously inspire us in real life, Miura focused on the way Guts actually struggles a lot more. In the way he stands up again against odds, it's not about giving a speech or proving to anyone your bravery and how you shall never give up. It's about standing up again and moving forward. As simple as that. And in a way, a case can be made that Miura's depiction is the realest one of all. And for being an inspiration for many of our favorite animes and video games, and a masterpiece through its amazing art and story, but most of all, for being a beautiful lesson we can all live by, we shall all give our thanks and respect in the memory of the genius that was Kentaro Miura. For in the end, only through pain can a man be shaped.